Welcome everybody to Virtual Reality Medicine and Surgery Inaugural Course 2020. My name is Jack Dunn, I'm a consultant and facial surgeon based at East Windsor, Queen Victoria Hospital and Brighton. I'm going to give you a little bit of background to the whole concept and how we came about delivering this course to you and the potential applications of virtual reality in medical education. So I guess the journey really begins with a course that I've been holding here for 3 years at East Windsor and Brighton. It's a category course which features virtual surgical planning and mandibular reconstruction using guided surgical techniques. We use a fibula free flap for mandibular reconstruction, pre-bent plates, and cutting guides. One of the few courses worldwide that hosts a virtual cadaveric approaches in virtual surgical planning. The course also hosts advanced microvascular surgery skills. For those of you established in microsurgery, you're already aware that microsurgery isn't just the anastomosis, it's beyond that. It's the setup of the surgeon, the setup of the system, setup of the vessels, understanding triangulation, how you manage salvage. And the third part of the course were soft tissue reconstruction using perforated free flaps and concept of chimerism for a personalised approach in reconstruction. So we hosted this course in sunny Brighton and in Squidston, and we were all set for this course to happen this year. All plans full steam ahead, but of course this happened to all of us and this changed massively our clinical practice. So the possibility of running a course, of course, was now no longer available to us, but actually delivering any kind of course in sort of close proximity between delegates and tutors could have had catastrophic effects. So we had to think outside the box as to how we deliver a course going forwards. I think the prospect of COVID being with us is unknown. It could be for some time, so we all need to learn to adapt. And the most important aspect of this, I guess, is understanding how we can still continue to deliver educational material, which is hugely important for our trainees, but appreciate the importance of social distancing. So we had a glut of webinars. Most of the specialties were delivering these sorts of webinars. We're now all very comfortable with using Zoom, GoTo, and Cisco, and Microsoft Teams. But most of these webinars are very one-dimensional, usually just didactic teaching, one-way interaction, sometimes two-dimensional with some Q&A at the end and some two-way interaction during the webinars. But I put my thinking hat on and I wanted to know how we could deliver educational material that's much more immersive and interactive than just a conventional webinar. Now, I've played the VR, I have a VR headset on my PlayStation, and really that's where it's grown from the gaming world. So I started having a little play and came up with this idea of virtual reality in medicine and surgery. But of course, VR is nothing new, it's been around for quite some time. And the concept or value in education has been somewhat held back. There's a summit on in 2020, which I'd encourage you to go to if you're interested in this technology. But why hasn't it taken off? And there's two reasons why it hasn't taken off. The first reason is because most people will try to make this a commercial exercise, and that adds zeros to the total cost of delivering this kind of material. If the costs are prohibitive, it's not likely to be utilised, and that's one of the key cornerstones of our concept of agreements, to deliver free training resources for anyone, anywhere. The second reason is people often want to run before they can walk, start to over-engineer, bring in very complex concepts of haptics and augmented reality, and that again makes it a very expensive endeavour. So we have used a stepwise approach of keeping it very simple, and understanding each of those steps before we move to the next. So we're not going to do anything complex and interactive with haptics. We're not going to use any augmented reality. We're going to have this as a simple interaction, short VR content, and then get your feedback first of all before we move to the next level. So the potential applications, of course it has applications in medical surgical education. I think it's huge at any stage of your career, from medical student to senior trainee and consultant level. It's great for demonstrating clinical techniques, and we posted some of these videos on our website. Useful for instrument setup, and again I've posted some videos, haven't set up the hand instruments for a while, and you just want a reminder, whether a nurse or a surgeon, it's useful for that. Haven't moved on to surgical procedures yet, but that will be the ultimate ambition, and particularly more about consent, GDPR, and also how we film and get the best view. But the real value is in 360 simulation. You don't need a 360 view in surgery, you need a 360 view in emergency medicine, anesthesia, understanding that as an educational tool, such as ATLS and ALS. We've also done some preliminary work with Galileo dissection, and I've demonstrated nicely that the quality of the 4K upstream upload is more than adequate for fine and active demonstration, including perforated flaps. Of course, it's also the role for patients, both in education, rehabilitation, and that's untapped and uncharted territory. And this is the website that we've set up, so www.virtualrealitymedicineandsurgery. It's four key points of this course, of this concept, which underpin it are new web training and immersive, but most importantly, free for trainees for anyone and anywhere. So if you tap, if you click onto the website, you can scroll down and see how the concept came about with some educational material on there, a bit of the background for us as well. But if you click on the specialty page, we've got an about page where we host the videos and how to convert your VR 360 video on your phone into a VR experience. But if you click on any of those subspecialties, we'll be adding content to that over the coming months and years. So if you have a look at this, for example, on the plastics specialty section, Adam Blackburn is demonstrating MSAT markup. We've got ACID demonstrating hand examination in VR mode. So if you click on any of those videos on your desktop, you'll be able to still have some sort of an immersive interactive experience because you can change the view to the perspective that you want. So it says Adam marking up George's calf for a medial sural artery perforator flap. And I'm just tapping and scrolling from different perspectives. And if you just scroll forward a little, you'll see that when he's marking out the relevant anatomy for the flap. So you can get the perspective you want. Important to consider GDPR implications as well as consent implications. So we've got a GDPR consent form on the website. If anybody wants to post anything, send it to us to host on our website. You will all receive the Striker headsets. These are Google 10-pound headsets that have been paid for and badged and endorsed by Striker. I'm really grateful for the support that they've given us. The headsets, it is worth you trying them on to see whether you're getting on with them. One, whether you can see the footage that we've already posted on the website, the quality is adequate for you, and they're comfortable. But if you find that they're not comfortable, then I'd suggest an alternative. This is from Amazon Prime, £20 headset, TechRise for iPhones. So make sure you get one that's compatible with your phone. What's useful with this is that as well as the phone padding, it has an adjustable interpupillary distance and also kind of just the focal depth. And if you find that the quality isn't quite good enough, certainly when we upload the 4K quality, it's worth getting this headset in addition, because you'll see that quality in the image. So now that you've got your headset, how can you watch the content? So there's two ways to watch the content, and again, these videos are on the About page. The first way to watch the content is to watch it on your desktop on a Facebook screen. So you just tap and scroll. This is one of my trainees who is watching on laptop on Facebook, and I'm in-house streaming to him, and he can change the view to the perspective that he wants. So that's one way of watching it, but this is a better way to watch it. So I'll talk you through this video so you're happy with the setup. So you need to make sure you've downloaded the YouTube app. That's really important. If you haven't downloaded the app, it's not going to work. You can't open the video directly. You have to open the YouTube link. Once you open that link, tap and scroll, move the phone to get the 360 perspective. But if you enlarge it and then put it into landscape mode, and then tap on the icon on the bottom right hand side, the goggles icon, your VR mode. And all you need to do now is put it into your headset and you're ready to go. Click on the landscape mode, and then tap the goggles icon on the right hand side, and you then have the VR mode. In it goes. So the important thing to remember is the default setting in quality resolution is low, 480, 720 usually. So if you want to get that 4K quality, you're going to have to adjust that setting. So we're going to be streaming in to Australia, streaming to Florida, and streaming to Jamaica. So the stepwise approach, working this whole concept up, was to demonstrate simple clinical examinations and tap and scroll on Facebook, followed by 360 on YouTube, in-house live stream, and out-house live stream streaming to Amsterdam. Such has been the progress and development of this. Now our specialty president has endorsed the project and has to develop a dedicated app which you can download the entire maxillofacial, all of maxillofacial surgery for in 360. So we've demonstrated the cadaver work, and the quality is easily good enough for perforator dissection, and what you're going to get is a perspective in which you can change the view to your preference. So of course we're going to have several cameras streaming through. We'll have a conventional 4K camera surgeon's view, which will be able to zoom. Second camera through the light, through 30 lights in the anatomy suite. There'll be a third camera 360 view, surgeon's view, and some other cameras on the track to see which to switch to as well. And we'll also look at the website. So the flyers you've seen, head and neck, maxillofacial plastics, day one and two. With lower limb reconstruction, facial deformity, facial quality, facial aesthetics. The second day also features, the third day rather, also features hands and surgery, and the fourth day are ENT techniques. We've got on day four, vascular surgeons and orthopedic surgeons, and breast surgeons demonstrating the various techniques. And then finally, on day five, we use 360 simulation of emergency medicine and anaesthetics. So I'm really grateful to the entire faculty who have getting this together. This is a big group of course, and we're just learning as we go along. And I guess the most important point that I'd like to make to you all is that we don't want to stamp the utility of this technology. And so we've kept it simple, with a 15-minute demonstration in May, followed with a conventional webinar, followed by a second short Gadabari demonstration day. 15 minutes. We need your feedback to understand this technology, and that feedback will be essential for future iterations of the course, and better help understand how we can give you true immersive VR experience in medical surgery. So enjoy the course.